Ryan, you mentioned after the game on Sunday, next step for you and Julio is to keep building with him being back in here now. What does that look like on the practice field and in games?
Yeah, just keep stacking good days together. You know, every bank rep matters. So, you know, whether it's in practice or games, any rep that we have together, we get to connect is a good thing. So just keep stacking those good days, and it'll pay off on Sunday.
How much does the pitch kind of change for you when he is out there on the field, Julio, that is, out there on the field with you?
I'm excited to have him out there. Obviously, love throwing the ball. He does some good things for us. You know, had a couple more opportunities that we weren't able to get him the ball down the field, which is frustrating for everybody. But, you know, I'm seeing some good things from him, so excited to have him back out there. And hopefully, you know, we can have some opportunities to connect those downfield throws.
Is it really critical to, even if you don't connect, just to get those on film so teams know that you guys are still capable of, you know, pushing the ball down the field?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, it's something that we want to connect on. So I don't know if they play us any differently, but I know that, you know, if we have an opportunity, we want to take advantage of it down the field.
What maybe gets your attention first?
You're talking about last year?
When you watch them.
Oh, when I watch
what they've
them,
done so far this year, maybe preparing for that game.
Yeah, they're a talented defense. You know, they fly around aggressive linebackers. Minka Fitzpatrick is all over the field. I was with him in Miami and respect him. He's a really good player. Their front is fast and aggressive. Obviously, Watts coming off the edge, Hayward on the inside. Just an overall a tough defense. They play a bunch of different fronts in base defense. They're going to give you every look in the book and make it tough on communicating and IDing. And then they're physical. I mean, I think that's what it comes down to is a physical defense that wants to make it tough on you.
The looks that maybe you don't see typically. I mean, do they do things that you sort of have to really go a little deeper with your film study this week?
Yeah, you know, some teams will do it, and Pittsburgh's included, is, you know, putting five or six bigs on the field, and then, you know, they'll walk wide around, and he was out, 56 was walking around. So make you account for a big guy in a situation or in a place, in a spot that a big guy is not normally. So makes it tough for the offensive line and communicating and knowing who we're going to.
A lack of shots downfield recently. Ryan, has it been more a function of what the defense is giving you or what you guys are trying to do to take yourselves?
Yeah, I think we've had opportunities and we've tried to get them off down the field. It just hasn't all panned out together at the same time. So something we'll continue to work at.
When a quarterback's taking a lot of hits and a lot of sacks, oftentimes it has some kind of mental effect on their game, at least subconsciously. But I talked to Pat about that yesterday. He doesn't seem to think that's the case with you. Nobody doubts your toughness and stuff, but you think there's something there?
I don't think so. I work really hard for there not to be. You know, I want to be able to stand in there and make, you know, tough throws in a tight pocket. And it's the NFL. There's going to be a lot of tight pockets, and you have to be able to find that fine line between standing in there and making the throw and you know, protecting yourself. So, yeah, something that I work really hard at and want to continue to do.
Ryan, how much do you feel like Ferk got going this past weekend? I know you would have liked to have that touchdown, but do you feel like maybe he's back to kind of finding some consistency? Because I know it's been a rough go up to that point.
Yeah, Ferk's been doing what we've asked him to do. You know, I think maybe his numbers haven't been producing, but, you know, you look at third downs, and a lot of times he's helping out, and he's an underneath route. So we were able to get him out into the route concept a little bit more this past game, and he produced. You know, you see conversions. So excited for him and the steps that he took, and hopefully we can build on it.
Last year we saw a lot of those, what they call drop it in the bucket throws that you guys had. Haven't seen that as much this year. What's the key to trying to find those and getting on the same page with the receiver on those?
Yeah, I think a couple things going to that is getting the right coverage. When you do have those play calls, being able to win and getting a good position by the wide receiver, protecting and having time to get the ball off down the field, and then obviously a good throw.
The COVID cases increasing in the NFL, is that something that's been talked about, you know, quite a bit here? And I wonder if you know, like, boosters are increasingly being encouraged here, or how does that stand?
Well, we understand, you know, this time of year, you know, sickness is going around and COVID included. So we want to be smart with the situations we put ourselves in as a team. Coach Vrabel talked about that this morning, and just making sure we keep the team at the back of our minds wherever we go. So obviously you're not going to be able to totally avoid anything. It's just kind of the world we're living in. But you can be aware of the situation you put yourself in and try to be smart.
It's too early, obviously, for any kind of victory lap or State of the Union address, but as you enter this sort of home stretch, do you like the position you put yourself in where if you do what you're supposed to do, you'll be where you want come January?
Yeah, no doubt. Obviously, things haven't been perfect for us up until this point, but we have ourselves in a good situation. But Coach Vrabel's talked about it, you know, for the last 2 weeks, is we're just getting started, have a lot of football out in front of us, and want to play our best football here down the stretch. So if we're able to do that, then we'll like where we end up.
This, Ryan, but can you describe your connection with AJ, you know, going all the way back to when you guys were both getting the second team reps, you know, in your first season here and how it's progressing? It seems like there's a little bit of a special connection there.
Yeah, I love throwing the ball, AJ, man. He's a great dude. I love being around him. He's a good friend, and he's fun to throw the ball to. He's easy to throw the ball to. He has a natural ability, obviously, to get himself open. He has a size, a strength. But there's some guys that are just easy to throw to. You know, it's your first time taking reps with them, and they're easy to throw to, and he's one of those guys.
Those are the main reasons? It's his size and his physicality? Those are the main reasons you say he's kind of an easy guy to throw to? Or?
Not necessarily. You know, I think just his feel for adjusting to the ball, the way he moves is easy to read. You know, all those things kind of play into it.
Would that, like, first practice or two with him, you sort of notice, like, hey, this guy's different?
Yeah, you kind of early on you can see that when you throw with a guy, just how easy it is to read their body language and how they move, how smooth they move. And then obviously, you know, he has a big catch radius and adjusts to the ball really well. So, you know, you put those things together and it makes for an easy target.
Brad, what are your thoughts on a guy like Roethlisberger, been doing this since 2004, playing at a high level, a couple Super Bowls, and this may be his last year, but it looks like he's not going to go down without a fight this year.
Yeah, no doubt. You know, I have a ton of respect for Ben and what he's done in his career. Obviously played at a high level for a really long time. You know, going back to his early days, he's shaking off three techniques and standing in the pocket, just unbelievably strong. And then even now, you know, they fall behind a couple times lately, and he's battling them back. You know, he's making great throws, putting themselves in positions to get back in the game and possibly win the game at the end. So you can't say that he's you know, changed a whole lot or going to go down without a fight. You know, he's still able to make those really good, tough throws and is leading his team to stay in games.
What's the atmosphere like at Heinz Field compared to maybe other places where you've played?
It's a great place to play. I love playing there. I think the last time I actually played there was 2014 in the snow, which was a fun experience. My first real snow game, you know, with more than just a dusting. You know, we went in for after warm-ups, came back out, and I think there was like 4 or 5 inches of snow on the ground. It was crazy how fast, you know, it came down. But yeah, it was a fun game. I remember being a super competitive game, great atmosphere, really cool stadium set right there on the rivers. And definitely when you think of an NFL football stadium, Pittsburgh is definitely one of those that comes to mind.
Pretty well in the conditions that day, or?
Yeah, we threw it. I don't remember how many yards or anything. You know, I can remember a couple touchdowns and we won the game. So those are things that stick out to me.
Did you wear a glove on your right hand, or did you go?
No, just bare hand.
Is that the game when Antonio stepped out of bounds on that crazy lateral play?
Exactly. Yeah, that was a wild play. I had a great vantage point. I was standing right on the sideline. I saw him step. I'm like, he stepped out. I knew when they threw it back to him. And he took off running. I looked down the sideline, and there was nobody on that side of the field. I said, uh-oh, this is bad shape right here. But thankfully, he stepped out.